Hi guys, a bit late than usual that we planned, but we finally watched episode 2, Stormborn.
Yep.
And yeah, good episode. It's just the wheels are turning now and progressing the story forward.
Yeah. Slowly picking up the pace.
Slowly picking up the pace.
We get a bit of action in this one at the end. Yeah. Game of Thrones usually do.
Yeah.
They'll have the action at the end of the episode.
Yep. Or, you know, start and then end, yeah, that kind of thing. But it was good, the fact that they've sort of quickened up the pace of people travelling.
Mm.
People just appear.
Certain travelling people get there very quickly. Still taking a 3-day time.
It's like eventually Grey Worm next episode will automatically be at Castle Rock.
Well, it looked like they were setting off.
Yeah. I think in the promo you see he put his helmet on, I think he was like saying goodbye to Melisandre. Missandei, whatever. But, yeah, this episode focuses obviously on Daenerys and how all the lords of Westeros are going to deal with it.
Her.
Yeah, both from the northern side and the last final houses that are with Cersei, and also the allies of Daenerys themselves. So the wheels are turning in the sense that Cersei is rallying her forces.
Yep.
You got the Tarleys, who obviously, is it Randall? Randall Tarley? Randall Tarley?
Probably, yeah.
He's like a really skilled battle commander, isn't he?
Yeah, like one of the best generals.
One of the best generals. So he's going to probably factor in at some point. But now I'm thinking to myself, the siege on Castle Rock, or whatever, is going to be separate from what Jaime's doing. Because Jaime's still at King's Landing.
Unless he goes to Castle Rock.
Yes. They're going by sea, aren't they? So I think maybe they might besiege it from the sea first, somehow. And then...
Well, to go by sea, they have to go all the way around the bloody island, don't they? Or that way. No, they wouldn't go that way.
Yeah.
They'd go that way.
I think they would, though.
Unless the fleet has been annihilated.
Yeah, that's the biggest talking point.
They've got to go across land.
Yes. That's the biggest talking point of this episode, obviously, when Euron's fleet absolutely destroys.
Yeah.
There's not even contest. It's not even, I thought...
It's not even an even fight. They just get a fucking sucker punched in the night, flaming meteors. I don't know how they're doing that.
It's like ballistas, isn't it? Or onages on... from
some
the
kind of flaming catapult, who were very accurate on, I say.
Yeah.
They just, like... come out of nowhere, and that ship that he built is a beast. Just smash it into theirs, fuck them over.
Yeah. I thought the trailers were showing the fact that that was going to be a bigger thing.
Maybe there's another fleet battle.
Maybe. There might be another one, but yeah. I don't think so, because I think it's expensive.
Yeah, and Euron goes beast mode and kills a couple of sand snakes.
Oh, yeah.
Who uses a fucking whip?
I know. It's not even a razor whip or anything like that. It's just like a whip. And the worst thing about it, she was like, I can take on the mountain.
No, you can't.
Or was it the other one that said she could take
one of them?
I think the one
with the spear wanted to take on the mountain.
They can't even take on... Euron's probably hammered.
Yeah.
He's probably drunk at this point.
He's hammered. He's killed a few people. He's in bloodlust mode. He's fucking people.
He's good. And I think the thing is, with the whole Yara... being captured and Tyrion jumping. Theon
going meek mode.
Yeah. I really thought they were going to do something differently with that scene. I thought he was going to charge at him, like with his sword drawn, and that's when the bolt was going to hit. Because where's the scene of them falling into the water with the fire? In the trailer, you saw two people fall in the water and there's fire. And that's, of course, a cut. That's a cut
Won't
scene.
Be a cut. It might have been, you know, when you see underneath the boat smashing into the other boat.
Yeah.
That I think might have been one I was thinking of, because you just see like two silhouettes.
Yeah.
You can see now it is obviously a boat. But
it's either in there we missed it, or it's just been deleted. But I thought Theon was going to charge at him, and then it was going to explode. He was going to fly into the water, mm-hmm, unconscious, something like that. Because I really did think that.
They could have gone for the standard. He runs. Euron cuts the throat, chucks her at Theon, and then just leaves.
Possibly.
That could have been another possibility.
But I think it just doesn't Theon's storyline doesn't make sense to me. I thought he was going to have some sort of redemption storyline where he was going to be blown into the water, and he was going to be like feel helpless, but he couldn't help her, and then he's got to get back on his get back on it. But no, he's just he literally just jumped off a boat.
He did.
And it's not like he doubts his fighting ability. He was
he was killing people left, right, and centre. He was doing quite well. And then I don't know if it was just seeing people getting cut and it reminded him of losing his dick or something. I don't know.
It looked like he was suffering some sort of trauma, though.
Yeah.
It was kind of weird the way it happened. And it's going to be interesting to see how his story fleshes out from here and whether or not Yara is going to be one of our correct people on our list. Yara's gonna die.
Which nail game many go, called it, fucking called it, she's dead.
Yeah. But I think
the Sand Snakes are dead.
Yeah, but
they were on our
honorable mentions. I think that Euron's not gonna bring Yara to Cersei. I think he's gonna keep her to himself.
Just Alaria, is that her name?
Alaria Sand.
Yeah, she's the prize or treasure, if anything.
Oh, I wonder what's gonna happen to her.
The mountain's gonna have his way.
Have his way and smash her head. Like,
he did what he did to Oberyn.
Oberyn.
Just get a little pop.
Oh, that'd be so cool. Oh, great. But that'll be next episode. Yeah. But other things we got, obviously, the battle plan drawn out by Daenerys. A lot of female strength when they were around that table. All the men were in the background.
Apart from Tyrion, the little dwarf,
Tyrion's that big, so he already has a disadvantage.
And the other one's like, don't listen to the smart men, they just die. Be a dragon.
Be a dragon. It's like, yeah, but you'd lost your entire family.
Yeah, how's that doing for you?
How's that doing? But yeah, it's good. Like, Cersei obviously is like rallying her lord, saying that she's going to do the same as my king.
Oh, and they got the ballista now.
They got that ballista. I love the way. He's like, we're working on something, yes. He's like, pull that lever, please. Fires it. Excellent. Read all these. No, that was it. That was the only one we had.
Do you know how long it takes to reload that? Five good men.
Five good men. And the material used for those bolts is very rare. And he's like, well, why have you made it then? I don't know.
It's a dragon. We went for the highest quality.
Yeah.
What do you want to use? Well, in sticks, they'll burn.
It was funny. Like those ballistas, obviously that's going to... I'm assuming a dragon's going to die at some point.
The green one.
Small one. And then obviously Arya's reunited with Hot Pie, briefly.
Yeah.
I was saying to you that she seemed very weird in that sequence.
Yeah, but she's kind of like, she doesn't want to talk to him. She just kind of like mumbles out a couple of words here and there.
And she's like, oh yeah. So does he do that? Yeah. And I just thought that it just sort of made it appear that she's not herself.
Maybe she's going a
she's
bit...
actually Ed Sheeran.
Well, maybe she's losing herself to the, she's becoming no one.
She's becoming finally no one.
Yeah.
Perhaps.
Until she heard that Big Bro Jon Snow is King of the North.
Yeah, and she decided to go back. I like how they showed that transition of, ooh, which way is she going? Is she going to King's Landing or is she going to the North? And when she turned around, there's just two people huddling with a coat on.
Yeah,
like, oh, it's really cold, obviously.
Well, no, because they had like the people in the carriage going, off to King's Landing we go.
True. But, yeah. And then she has a reuniting with Nymeria.
Yeah, the direwolf. Fuck you, Arya. You're not good enough to hang with this pack.
Yeah. She's got a life of her own now. She's got her own pack in the Riverlands. But I think what's going to happen, Arya's going to get into some sticky situation and she's going to come and help her.
To be fair, having a pack of wolves at your beck and call could be quite handy.
That could be cool. But I think it's going to be like... I know it's different in the books because... Arya has a different relationship. I think she can warg into things as well. Arya can. I think in the book she has some sort of ability, or she has like wolf dreams or something. Some sort of connection. I'm sure she has. I can't remember my mate told me that. But I think what might happen is it's just going to be like a sort of last moment. She's going to rip some people's faces off.
I miss the direwolf. The direwolves are cool.
Yeah, where's Ghost?
Ghost is still beyond the wall, isn't he? He pissed off.
No, he's there.
No, he'd be on the wall.
How is he on the wall?
He walked away. I don't know why.
No, he didn't walk
he
away.
He did.
No, he didn't.
When? I can't remember.
It was
like a couple of seasons ago.
No, he was there when Jon Snow was dead. Remember, he's the one that sort of initiated it, because he got up, didn't he? He got up when he was coming back alive. And that was the last time we saw him, I think.
Where is Ghost? Is he still at the wall?
No, he'll be at Winterfell somewhere.
Maybe he's chilling in Winterfell then.
He'll be somewhere. He'll be doing something. He's always doing something.
He's just off and about. Well, I know that the husky or whatever they used to play Ghost died.
Did it?
Yeah.
No.
So that might be why.
Did he die? Why? Of old age?
I don't know. I'm not too sure.
Oh, right.
I just think I saw. An article saying that
it's a white dog. They'll get another one.
Yeah.
But I do hope that's he's going to reappear, and the season needs to start. There's obviously a battle next episode as well. So
yeah.
Well, these are starts for the battle. So I do hope that they don't short changes on these battles. Like the one at the end of this episode was really short. Good, but yeah. Short. But yeah. I hope they do shorts
again.
If they do short ones, they just cut the episode.
Yeah, they can't have a short battle for Castle Rock. That's got to span at least two episodes.
Probably. Hopefully. But I tell you what, though, is Gendry going to save Theon?
Just him floating on this little piece of wood, like Gendry, just muscle bound, like, get in here! I'm going to King's Landing.
We didn't see the Hound this episode either.
No, we didn't. So they're probably just on their way north. Gonna meet up with some wildlings.
Yeah, it's gonna be good. It's gonna be good seeing what happens. But yeah. We've only got five episodes left. Yeah, five episodes.
Five episodes for Cersei to die in.
Yeah, it needs to hurry up.
Yeah,
big time. Even when Cersei dying, it seems like she's going to be really far away from any kind of things. That's why I think Jaime's going to kill her. Someone's got to kill her.
It's either Jaime or Tyrion. I'm going to go with Jaime.
Yeah.
He's going to give her a gold backhand.
And breaks her neck.
As soon as she starts burning people, that's it. Well, actually, she's already burned. He's blowing people up. That's much worse.
Yeah, turn everyone to ashes.
Yeah.
But yeah. But, I mean, is there anything else we've missed? Pretty straightforward episode, really.
Yeah.
So Jon Snow and Ser Davos have gone riding off.
Jon Snow attacked Littlefinger.
Oh yeah, strangled him.
Like you see, like with one hand, and like
no. He had to reach up there to get him.
Yeah.
Because he's too much taller than him. Just like, poof, touch my sister.
Or slash cousin, which I don't know yet.
Yeah. Which is going to be the big reveal in the end of the season.
But he's like, Jon Snow leaves. Bran arrives. Bran goes off. Arya comes back. Arya leaves. Yotho comes back.
Yeah, it's gonna they're gonna miss each other.
And just fans are like, what's happening? Why aren't I going anywhere?
They're never going to all meet up probably. They're always gonna miss each other and they're never gonna be on
screen.
That's
how this season's gonna end. They're gonna all be reunited, it's gonna be the Stark family again.
All on screen at the same time.
And Bran's gonna be like, I have something to tell you. You are not the son we all thought you were.
Yes, you are not the bastard son. You are actually...
Well, you are a bastard son.
You are still a bastard son, but you're not our bastard son. You're a cousin.
And like, you think back to that night with Daenerys, to swear allegiance.
It's like, oh God! Just does that cuts off. Just his face going. You know, the bit in IT Crowd where it's like, I used to be a man, it's like, oh God! Used to be a man. Yes. I love that show. Anyway, we'll leave it there.
Yeah.
Looking forward to episode 3.
Looking forward to all of them.
Yeah, I'm on holiday next week, so I think we're going to have to do a double header.
Yeah, episode 3 and 4 the week after, won't we?
Double review, double header.
Not that you care.
Not that you guys care, but smash it out.
Cheers for watching.
But yeah, cheers for watching. See you guys.
Couple of weeks. Couple of weeks.
2 weeks. Yeah, maybe next week. No.
We'll see how it works out.
Yeah. Anyway, see you guys later.
See ya.